Technology. It shapes and reshapes our world. The hardware and the software make us aware of better ways of doing things. For work or for leisure, technology can improve our lives
and re-energize our lifestyles.
We can create it or we can adapt it. The technology of the present can help us prepare
for a future perfect.
That was a very quiet way to start the show. Hi, I'm Tony Velasquez. The start of every school year in the Philippines focuses attention on the usual problems, the lack of classrooms, the lack of teachers, the lack of books and other supplies. And then there are the private school tuition hikes that lead to an exodus to public schools. Even with a budget increase of more than 5 billion pesos, the Department of Education is still struggling to provide for basic student needs. This year, the DepEd is turning to technology to keep track of which schools needs its attention the most. The website checkmyschool.org is an interactive map where school officials, parents, students, and the public at large can provide details of services and facilities existing or lacking in public schools throughout the country. The website aims to ensure that these data are immediately fed to the DepEd. And joining us to tell us more about this system is Jecel Censoro of the Affiliated Network for Social Accountability, or ANSA, East Asia Pacific. Jecel, thank you very much for coming to the show.
Yeah, thank you so much for the invitation.
And this website, checkmyschool.org, has been up since January, is that right?
Yes.
How has it been doing so far?
Yeah, it's doing good. So basically what we did is that we had road shows after the launching. The launching actually coincides with the signing of the memorandum of agreement with the Department of Education.
Okay.
So after that we had road shows in different sites. So we had in Luzon we have Baguio and Benguet, then okay. NCR, then we also have Tacloban, Leyte.
Right.
And then we have Pagadian and Zamboanga City.
All right. And with these road shows, who did you invite to attend?
Well, we had an orientation with school stakeholders. These are students, teachers, parents, and of course, since Check My School is a social accountability initiative, we also invited someone from the mayor's office, the local school board, and of course, the administration of the school.
Of course, kailangan nandun si mayor. Anyway, so how many public schools are there nationwide as per the DepEd's count and as per ANSA's own statistics?
Actually, there are 46,000 schools nationwide.
Okay.
But with Check My School, the data which is uploaded in the website, it's around 8,600.
Initially.
As of now. Yeah, but because it has the, those are the schools which has the global positioning system. So we use that for the mapping.
Okay. Now, why would these schools have GPS?
These are actually data which originally came from the Department of Education themselves because they also have their own initiative of mapping.
Okay.
But what we did is something like that, but this time it's more of towards community. So it's not triggered by the government but by the community so that they can
So residents of the communities provide the information about the schools that are within their area.
Yeah, and as well as the people inside the school. So the parents, the PTA, the student council, so they're the ones who provide the information.
Okay. Now would that assume that the people who do live in that community are technologically equipped to send GPS data?
Not really. So that's why we also have our volunteers from outside. So we also mobilize others, for example, alumni of that school who are already working. And also we have this innovation we call information infomediary. These are information intermediary. Information intermediary.
Information intermediary or
infomediary. So basically what they do is that they bridge the gap. So they serve as the something like they go to the school and then provide the information about the website and then gather the information and bring it to the website.
Okay, and this could be anybody?
Yeah, this could be anybody, a volunteer.
A volunteer.
From, yeah, that's a volunteer.
All right, now how did this idea come about? Tell us a little bit about the background of ANSA and why checkmyschool.org was conceptualized. I do understand that it's hosted by the Ateneo School of Management as well. You're getting some technical support from Google. But how did the idea originally form?
Well, actually, the idea is really we conducted consultations with the Department of Education and also the community. So we asked, what's wrong with the Department of Education? How come every June it's still there? Like,
sakit naman ang tanong mo, what's wrong with the Department of Education?
No, not
the
really.
Answer, everything.
No, it's actually how come there's still those news? Isn't it resolved or isn't it reported?
Paulit-ulit yung
recurring
problema.
So they said it was frustrating. How come it seems like it's going to the whole bureaucracy that the information doesn't reach the proper authority so that they can respond to the for example.
Yes.
They reclamo what they say.
So for example, you know, we get the recurring problems of shortage of classrooms, shortage of textbooks. Even if there are classrooms and textbooks, it's like the kids themselves don't have the money to go to school, maybe transportation.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the kinds of problems that may have to be identified in each of these schools.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yes.
Are there categories of problems that the volunteers should just look for, or it's just randomly what they're looking for kung may problema?
Well, basically what we do is that the basic services provided to the school.
And that's itemized.
Yeah, we have a form. So okay. those are the ones that really has a template inside the website.
Right.
So the number of toilets, the number of textbooks, those basic information.
Ooh, okay. That's pretty complete.
Yeah, we have, yeah.
Yeah. So, okay, you started out at about 8,000 out of, what is it, 44,000 schools nationwide?
46,000
schools nationwide. That was in January, so we're like almost in the fourth quarter of the year.
Mm-hmm.
How has the updates progressed since then? How many more schools have been added?
Currently, we have this activity we call Check and Run. So it's basically the...
Not Check and Run.
Something like that. So,
check and run.
So it's basically the launching part of the Check My School school data validation activity.
Okay.
It's something like the Brigada Escuela, but this time instead of painting the classroom, we mobilize citizens who will then help validate information. So basically these volunteers go to the school, basically count the number of textbooks, chairs in actual, and then send it to the website.
Yeah.
So that happened, that was launched last August 20, and then it will end on September 10. It coincides with the BIS, or the Basic Information System of the Department of Education, their reporting system. So it ended last July, and what we did is validate those information on the ground.
Does that cover all 44,000 schools?
As of now, we only have 13 sites of around 3,000 schools. So from the 8,000,
we add 3,000 more.
Something like
that. All right. From your perspective, and then I go back to my question, ANSA, how did it begin? I mean, as an organization?
The Affiliated Network for Social Accountability in East Asia Pacific, so that's the whole name.
Yeah.
So it's a regional network working on social accountability.
Okay.
The idea is basically constructive engagement with the government to provide better service delivery.
Does ANSA also have a similar project in other countries?
Yeah, the Check My School. It's about the, because Philippines is the pioneering project. It's actually the pilot.
Wow.
So we will bring it to the Indonesia sometime next year, probably.
So you're experimenting with the Philippines to begin with.
Because it's...
We're always the guinea pig, but in a good way.
Yeah, because we have laws to be able to support the project. We have the procurement law, and there's actually enabling environment where people are actually...
So you have a framework enticing. Where it's supposed to be easier to monitor the steps that the government takes to provide public services.
Yeah, and of course our citizens are actually eager to be part of the monitoring and of course the governance. And it's actually Pinoy's way, right? Transparency and
voluntarism.
Social accountability.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so the aim of checkmyschool.org, from what I've been reading, is to entice benefactors, you know, like private organizations, non-government organizations, to contribute maybe to a particular school that may be lacking in facilities, right? Have there been any promises or pledges at all, or even concrete action being given by benefactors to schools that have already been mapped?
Actually, the idea is actually to trigger the Department of Education to bring better service delivery.
Okay.
So far with that, with the DepEd, we actually have this project in Leyte, the Gobaldon building. So it's actually...
Gobaldon building.
Yes. Last May, they have a problem because their building, the construction of their building was stopped. So through Check My School, the people, the principal, reported it to our info media.
Okay.
And then this was then The report was sent to the
Central. This is in May of this year?
Yes, okay. May of this year.
Okay.
So that report was sent to the Department of Education Central.
Yeah.
And then they, after 3 days, they responded, and now the school is functioning. 800 students.
And responded?
Yeah, Department of Education responded.
So why was it stopped in the first place?
I think there's a problem with the contractor. So.
Ah, okay. So yung mga problems na ganon can be pointed out in the website, no?
Yeah.
By your intermediaries, and then pwedeng the usual bureaucratic, di ba, machinery should be activated again to address the problem.
Yeah. Okay. Or shorten it.
Or shorten it to fast track.
Fast track. Yeah.
So actually, kick it. Tuloy. Checkmyschool.org is like a kick in the pants, di ba? If you put it that way, parang pagkukupad-kupad, sipain mo para bumilis, di ba?
Something like that. So we have the
that's a Filipino way. Dapat karinyo brutal eh. Di ba? May halong karinyo, sige na naman, pero may konting, di ba? Or dapat gata. Which I think is a good thing, right? So getting people involved in helping schools, I'll go back to my question. Sabi mo kasi DepEd yung kumilos eh. But my question was, private organizations, non-government organizations, have they been pitching in since checkmyschool.org began in January?
Actually, when UCPB approached us on how they can help, so they asked us if there's any school which they can help to provide toilets. So we're working on that now.
Toilets?
Yeah, toilets. So through the Check My School, they look at what schools in Manila needs help in toilets, providing toilets, so something like that.
So it's UCPB.
Yeah, and there are other
companies
also.
Providing help with toilets.
And of course, Air 21. Air 21 helps
and
in mapping.
A freight forwarding company.
They help in providing the GPS, finding the GPS for each school.
You know, parang hindi ko maisip yung corporate fit na no. Parang when you think about sabihin mo ng plumbing, no, indoor plumbing or stuff like that. Parang isipin mo, madami naman mga parang indoor plumbing companies dito who may be willing to pitch in, no, but it strikes me as strange. It's a bank and a freight forwarding company that's actually more involved in giving kids proper toilets. Di ba? Dapat merong from that sector involved, di ba? Yung mga mahilig mag may expertise in putting up toilets. I'm
probably
just thinking aloud.
Yeah.
Not for you to answer. It's a rhetorical question. All right. Okay. Well, checkmyschool.org. How is it maintained? I mean, is this government funded and then also funded by private donations? How do you keep your upkeep nung database?
Well, with regards to the website itself, it's actually funded by the ANSA East Asia Pacific as of now, which is, of course, funded by World Bank.
Ah, okay. So you get World Bank funding.
Yeah.
How much is put into this every year?
Which one? The website?
Yes.
We with the hosting or the server of the website, it's around $500.
$500 a month?
A month.
A month. Okay. I understand because I was checking your website, and you do need more people to, you know, pitch in, maybe volunteer the services to maintain the database. That's still something that you need, right?
Yes, of course.
More people to maintain a database.
It's actually to provide data from the school. So what they can do is adopt
more
a school.
So intermediaries.
Yeah, volunteers and intermediaries. So they can adopt a school and then serve as a volunteer for that school, where they can serve as the gatherer of the data and upload it to the website.
Okay. Now, when you go to the website, and maybe people just listening now, not exactly in front of their computers. Now, you go to the website, do you have to register or create a login name? What do you do?
Yeah, you have to register because the data inside Check My School is an important data and a sensitive data. So we have to make sure the integrity of the person who's getting into the website.
Right.
Then once you're registered, you just log in. And then all the actions you do, it's actually registered in our site. You can post videos, something like a Facebook for school. So something like that's the
something
school
like
page.
Facebook. Okay, cool. So you started in Luzon. You know, you have pilot areas in Luzon, Visayas, and in Mindanao. Is there like a target growth for your database year to year?
Yeah.
You added how many? 3,000 schools, right? Since January.
Oh. Yeah. So we started with a roadshow, right? The four pilot schools. As of the moment, it's already 13 areas.
13 areas.
So there's additional nine areas out of the four before.
Okay.
So
per year, how many do you think should be added to the database?
As of now, since it's just pilot, so we're still looking at how we can work on the website and the community mobilization.
Yeah.
But hopefully, we can get the whole 46,000. So we can get the...
Within a matter of what period?
We're looking at another 2 years.
2 years?
Perhaps. Because okay. It's kind of... The other schools are far, so
I can understand, yeah. Yeah. Some of these schools, parang hard to reach by conventional transportation. Much more or less yung GPS pa. So, you think maybe you can complete the mapping in the next 2 years. Yeah. And once you do that, parang it should be easier now to monitor no, yung condition ng mga schools na ito, yeah. And to get the depth ed to act on these yeah. issues. Mm.
And also to get a more relevant and a more really with integrity data about the Department of Education. Yeah. You have the analytics okay. of the school.
So you can post based on the template, sabi mo, no? Yung mga mm-hmm. certain checklist kung ano yung kulang, mm-hmm. yung meron. And you can add photos ba and video?
Yeah.
You get to the site, right?
Yeah.
So parang makita mo talaga kung ano yung actual conditions.
And then there's also something like a wiki, so you can write an article about your school. And then, yeah, there's of course, you can text also. So there's an SMS feature, the 2948.
All right, so all of these things, they can check out the details on how they can provide the data mm-hmm. on the website, checkmyschool.org, which is what we're showing now on the screen. You check it out mm-hmm. and see how you can also become an infomediary.
Yeah, and a volunteer for the school.
Volunteer for the school. All right, well, pretty good. I think I tried to check it out. Medyo matagal na mag-load, or maybe it's just the internet in the office, I don't know.
Yeah, we're still fixing, because... there's a since it's a sensitive data, like the government websites, government. There are a lot of spammers and hackers, so we're fixing that.
Firewall.
Yeah, firewall.
Firewall. All right. Well, Jecel Censoro from ANSA East Asia Pacific, thank you very much for coming to the show.
Thank you so much.
Good luck to the project. Very worthwhile to support. Hopefully, a lot more infomediaries will come in to take a look.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
All right. Coming up. To take a look at how ordinary brochures can be turned to interactive presentations thanks to AR or augmented reality, keep it here on Future Perfect.